In this screencast, I'm going to show you how you can dynamically name arrays in Excel. So when you add items to a table, for example, the name is automatically going to update. So we've got a table of student ID numbers that correspond to hypothetical students here. And we want to be able to put into a cell here the student's name, and then it'll output the student ID number of that corresponding student. We can easily do this using the Vlookup function. And I'm going to first name this array, I'll just call it data. And I can type in here Vlookup. The lookup value is our name. The array is our data. Column index that we want to be output is the second column. And again, we can make this a lot more complicated. We could have all sorts of different columns of data that correspond to a student. And then I'm going to put in false here, which requires an exact match. And you can see that when we do that, it spits out that student's student ID number. Now, what if we wanted to add another student? So for example, I don't know, Chester. We want to add, and we had a random student ID number. If you look at our data array, it's rows 2 through 7, but we haven't been able to add Chester to that. Okay, so Chester and his corresponding student ID number is not part of data. So if we wanted to, I could go up here to Formulas, Name Manager, I could edit data. So now, instead of being rows 2 through 7, I could add that on, and then I could click OK. So now when we looked up, for example, Chester is now part of data, and it spits out his student ID number. This is somewhat inconvenient because if we want to keep adding students and student ID numbers, again, we could have all sorts of columns of data here. It becomes kind of inconvenient. So one thing we can do is dynamically name this array. So I'm going to go into the Name Manager. I'm going to edit data since we already have made that. And here, instead of the fixed array here, I'm going to type in a formula, and it's going to be based upon the offset formula. So we can type in different formulas if we want into this bar, typical Excel formulas. So I'm going to use the offset. Before we do this, let me show you what the offset function does in Excel. If I type in offset in a cell, you start with a reference, and then it's the rows away from that reference, the columns away from that reference, and then it's the height and width of the corresponding vector that you want. So if I wanted to start in cell A1 as my reference, so that would be my reference, but I really want to start my array with Jacob, that would be one row down, so I'd put a 1 here. We're not going to change the columns, so that's going to be 0, because I still want to be in A. I just want to be one cell down. And the height of that, in this case, would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And the width would be 2. Okay? So that's how we would use it. We wouldn't use it here in this cell, but if I used offset A1, 1, 0, 7, 2, that would be referring to cells A2 through B8. I can make this more sophisticated. Instead of the 7, right, let's say I kept on adding records here, student names and student ID numbers, I can put another formula in there, count A. So count by itself just counts numbers. Count A counts pretty much anything that's not blank. And I'm going to do count A of column A. So in this case, we have 8 rows, and that would be 8 items. And I'm going to subtract 1 because I don't want the name to be part of that array. So I would use that, and then the width would be 2. If I had a bunch of columns, I could use count A, and I would do like the row, and that would give us our width of the corresponding array. So again, I'm not going to put that into this cell. So I'm going to escape out of there. I'm going to go back into my Name Manager. I'm going to edit data, and here I'm going to type in offset. So I'm going to start in A1. I'm going to offset down one row, 0 columns. Then the height of our array is going to be count A of column A. And I'm going to subtract 1 because I don't want the first row to be part of my array. And the width is going to be 2. Okay, so when I do that, I click OK. And then we close the name manager. So if I go up here to the name manager and type in data, enter, it has selected A2 to B8 as our data array. Now, when I add something like Harold, now what you notice is if I type in data up here, because I had that formula for how we determine what the data array is, when I press enter, it now recognizes up through row 9. And I could type in Harold here to check, and it spits out the corresponding student ID number. And then if I wanted to delete a row, let's say I wanted to delete Lisa, I can delete and go up here to data and notice that that's our array. So this is how you can dynamically name an array so that if you have to add stuff to it or subtract information, it's always updating that array name.